including 15 ministerial levels or head of agency meetings. Many of the socio-cultural events hosted by India were the first of its kind in the framework of the SCO. The designation of Varanasi, Kashi, as the first ever SCO cultural and tourist capital for 2022-23, I think deserves special mention. It was our endeavor to create new verticals of cooperation in SCO, and as an example, I can cite the field of startups and innovation, traditional medicine, science and technology, empowering youth, and reviving the Buddhist heritage amongst the SCO member states. The work to implement these verticals is already underway, and it is being spearheaded by India. We are also committed to strengthening and further deepening the cooperation within the framework of SCO, and many of our initiatives and steps were in that direction. We have opened up new areas of cooperation and intensified engagement among member states. We hope to continue the momentum of our interaction, and we are obviously looking forward to the summit in July. In the course of these 2 days, I also held fruitful bilateral interactions with my counterparts from Russia, China, Uzbekistan, Kazakhstan, Tajikistan, and Kyrgyzstan. All ministers reaffirmed their support to India as the chair of SCO and expressed their appreciation for the contribution of India to that organization. I also met the Secretary General of the SCO and discussed the diversification and the deepening of SCO agenda. As regards the bilateral relationships, let me start with Russia. FM Lavrov and I noted the progress that has been made in our economic cooperation. We exchanged views on a number of regional and global developments. Since the G20 meetings are ongoing, and there's a BRICS foreign ministers meeting which is coming up soon, these two were also the subject of our discussion. Where FM Qingang of China is concerned, much of our attention, I think predictably, went to the disengagement issue in the Western sector. Yeah, but here again, the G20 and BRICS featured in the talks because China is a member of both groupings. With Minister Saidov of Uzbekistan, it was a warm first meeting. We took stock of our bilateral ties and agreed to have another conversation soon. This was also the case with Deputy Prime Minister and Foreign Minister Nutliu of Kazakhstan. With my Tajik and Kyrgyz counterparts, Foreign Minister Sirajuddin and Kulubayev, now they are long-standing friends with whom we have a rolling, ongoing conversation. Some of the subjects which came up in the meeting with them were overlapping with those of the others in Central Asia. They included connectivity, counterterrorism, health, trade, and energy. With all the Central Asian ministers, we agreed that the India-Central Asia format meetings in different domains should take place at an early date. So the overall sense that I would like to share with you is that of a productive SCO Council of Foreign Ministers meeting. I think it was useful in preparing the ground for the summit.